today on the dais, the president of the Indian Machine Tools Manufacturing Association, Honorable Ramdas Ji, Director General and CEO, Mr. Anu, Mr. Indradev Ji, and the Joint Secretary from my department, very enthusiastic one, Honorable Secretary, and the all great dignitaries, manufacturers, exhibitors who are present here. It's really an honor for me to be here to address you. Hardly a week ago, I was invited for the association. I was invited by an association to address their function. On 30th May, I took an oath to become the Minister of the Government of India, Honorable Prime Minister of the country, Narendra Modi ji, entrusted me with this department, Heavy Industry Department. I could have my own company, the Hindustan Machine Tools, and so many others are there. But when I see through that, what is exactly happening around, I always feel, you know, it's a painful feeling for me. When I see the companies are not able to make profit, they are sickening, they are becoming weak, some of them are little bit going ahead. On the other side, there is a climate change, the farmers are worried, drought is going on. So what is my concern is that? My concern that every company, every manufacturing company, which has been with the fit, they should not only become strong in their field, but they should prosper in such a way that the company should go ahead to such an extent that they should generate employment also and sustain the development also. Sustainable development is required. When I see all those things, today I purposely came here, not only to see your expo, but I always think what is happening from my childhood. We used to learn, you know, even a cutlery. Oh, this is made in Germany. This is made in France. This is made in the what we are doing there. So therefore, the Honorable Prime for the country has thought that let us go for Make in India. So you are the people who will make India successful. It is in your hand to make it successful. Whatever help you need from my ministry, tell me, I am there with you to extend almost all cooperation in what you require. So that only thing is that your product should be competitive, should be the best among the world's products, whichever it may be. Now, because of the open economy, open market economy, in India we see in auto sector also, number of companies have come. In my childhood, only two cars used to be there. One is Fiat, another is Ambassador. But I don't think anybody is using Fiat. The Fiat engines were good. The company is manufacturing other cars, but engines are of Fiat. Mercedes, they have their own engines. The first engine, using the engine of the auto sector company. See, therefore, what exactly my ministry will do in this case? What we have done, the Honorable Prime Minister and the Finance Minister have said, okay, that to work all those companies which are existing in this country, were having a turnover of 400 crores, their income tax has been reduced to 25%. The rate of income tax has been reduced to 25%. It was much more than that. So that's a help the ministry, the government wants to do it. When I see that the capital goods policy we have in 2016, we have derived the capital goods policy. There is only thing. Just now Mr. Ramdas was telling me that here the exhibitors are here, they have come with the solutions. It's a good thing. But when we talk about the carbon emission, we have not come with the solution. I appeal to all of you. We are going to BS6 for what? Only thing to reduce the carbon emission. We are going for electrical vehicles for what? To reduce the carbon emission, the pollution. Now, therefore, I appeal to all industries. Do we think of a manufacturing of a battery? All batteries will be imported now, make in India. There is an opportunity for you. Go for manufacturing of batteries also. Let us think of that. But at the same time, think of a disposal of the battery too. Because initially when we went for electronics, we never thought of it. Then later we started thinking, what to do with the e-waste? So tomorrow if the batteries come, how many years batteries will leave, I don't know. Or that technology will sustain, that also I don't know. Because there is, in the horizon, some hydrogen vehicles will come. So this technology is more changing. We are not in dearth of brilliance. The Indians are much more great. Who is working in NASA? Our own Indian engineers are there. So are we dearth of intelligence, brilliance, technologies? Use your technology. And wherever you want to use it, and if there is where you need some help, either by the way of policy or something, so go ahead. See, in Bangalore, in Tumkur, our own university must have told you just now, we have an expo over there, permanent. Use it. Vacant plots are there, permanent exposure is there. Then make use of it. Whatever you need, tell us. I just ask her to. Why not open it in Mumbai also, in Delhi also, permanently, so that the people around the world can come. Don't think that everybody has gone to that standards, or US standard, or some of the developed countries. How many developed countries are there? The world is about so many hundreds and hundreds of states. Handful of people are there. And look at China. Yesterday some people came to me and said that we are keep a technology which will create a cooling, not by water, but by air. So that technology has come. Now that technology, only thing is that, how much money it requires to install, how much period it will sustain. When we talk about the battery, I have always an apprehension in my mind. The battery, 24 volt battery, how much the vehicle will run? 100 kilometers, 200 kilometers. If it has to run from, suppose Delhi to Gurgaon, Delhi to somebody else, Agra, then in that case, it has to travel for so long, then how much the battery will sustain? The battery has to run for nearly 3 hours, 4 hours, whatever, then you are maybe 400 kilometers. But then again, one issue is important. The price of the vehicle is increasing because of the battery cost. But today, you are getting a vehicle for 10 lakhs, 6 lakhs. If you go for a battery, then the price of the vehicle will increase to 15 lakhs. Again, there will be impact on the sale of the vehicle. The sale of the vehicle, if it is reduced, then the impact on the revenue of the country. So all those things are vicious circle. Within that vicious circle, we have to come up. We should share this. I don't feel that we are here as the rulers and we dictate the terms. We should not do that. I am open on this. We are not that, genius people or move everything, versatile, that as if we know everything in this world. No. We are open to suggestions. We are open to corrections too. We are open to go for a development. When we talk about the development of technologies, what exactly we are doing? Are we part to that of the world, developed world? India is a developing country. So my Prime Minister always thinks of you. I just told you that regarding the Tumkur, Bangalore, we have that center over there. We have another center, from the ministry, we are providing support to machine tool industry for development of a new technology through centers such as MTDC, AMTDC, IIT Madras, CMTI Bangalore, etc. We are developing new technology for machine tool industry. Further, the ministry has set up 10 common engineering facility centers to facilitate the needs of the manufacturing center. We have further enhanced the strength of the machine tool industry to develop its capabilities through industrial cluster. One such park is being developed in Karnataka near Tumkuru, close to Bangalore, with the support of the Karnataka. Why not use it? And last one, important one is that you all are here. I will appeal to everyone of you. just don't exhibit your product or your solution. Reach out to all these people and see what they are doing, whether we are in that country or we should exchange the technology. We should interact, we should share. So why not go? In my industry, see, in my industry, number of industries are closed down almost. Two things I will appeal to you. One is that either go for a joint venture. Joint ventures among yourself, joint ventures with foreign companies, if they are there, or joint ventures with us. If you are, we are really, we do certain things over here. So paper technology, we had a Hindustan paper company. But many reasons, various reasons may be there. It was dark, it has not been liquidated. Somebody should come ahead. Let us do something. And I am here worried about, again I am telling you, one is the employer. With this technology, we should be able to generate employment too. Losing an employment like Robo will not survive the country. Because our country has a major issue is of population. When you compare any European country which has got a very meager population to that of India, 130 crores, you cannot keep the high speed. And therefore, Balasar Thakur is to say, if the industry survives, the employees will survive. If the industry prospers, the employees will prosper. For during this expo, I have been invited. I wish all the best and express my sincere feeling that not only you should sustain, but you should grow, you should prosper in a such a way that tomorrow your name should be taken in the world. That this is the product, this is the company from India, which product is competitive throughout the world, cheaper, best is Indian product, unlike China. Thank you very much. All the best to you.